As schools in West Michigan prepare for a safe return to classes, so are bus drivers.
But drivers in one district have some concerns they'd like to see fixed before kids step onto their buses. Lauren Embers joining us live after speaking with the union president in Portage today. Lauren?
Yeah, Derek and Janice, I got a chance to speak with her earlier this afternoon, and she was just saying, you know, they have a lot of concerns. Their buses are going to be out on the roads behind me soon enough, and they just want to make sure that whenever people are on the bus, that it's not only safe for the kids and the students, but it's also safe for them as well.
We'd like it if they would actually listen to people that are doing this job, as they listen to the teachers.
Portage Public Schools Bus Drivers Association asking the school district to listen to their concerns ahead of the start of classes next week.
We love the kids. We're really interested in their safety, and we want to make sure that it's a good school year for everybody.
Which includes bus drivers. So union president Kathy Adkins says they've been meeting with the district asking for a plan to keep kids and drivers safe.
Yesterday we were told that the buses will be full capacity. And of course, when there's full capacity, there's no social distancing.
And she says they're not doing temperature checks for kids before they get on the bus. So drivers are afraid they might contract the virus and spread it to others.
It feels really scary. A lot of the drivers are, as I said before, older, and they have significant others at home that they're afraid that they'll take the sickness home to.
And she says they also don't have the proper protection to last throughout the school year.
We do not feel we have enough PPE. We're given a package of 5 KN95 masks and told that we're going to use those for 10 days. Well, that's not 10 uses for us.
They were given hand sanitizer, but she says that's not enough. They're hoping they can come to a resolution soon with the district because time is ticking.
It's not just totally us. We want them to be happy with what we're doing, but we also want to make sure that we feel safe in our jobs, which is pretty much what everybody wants.
And that, it seems to be, is what everybody wants. I also got a chance to speak with, over the phone, the superintendent of Portage Public Schools, Mark Belane. And I just took some notes from our conversation, and he was just saying that there is a plan in place and that safety is the priority. Face shields will be given to drivers if they would like one. The seats behind the bus drivers will remain empty, and that kids, when they get onto the bus, they will come in through the back, and that's also how they will be offloaded. But he says they're also open to talks and suggestions. They're going to see how the first few days go to see the number of students that actually use the bus, because he knows that this year several parents and families opted out of doing that, but they're going to wait after those first few days and then they will make further adjustments. Reporting live here in Portage, Lauren Edwards, Fox 17 News.
All right, Lauren.